Hi guys, welcome to my channel. I am Anissa and this is my friend Rory.
And hello.
We've been friends on Instagram for a while now. So
I don't know, we started following each other around the beginning of when I did makeup. It was shortly after, so it's been almost 2 years, maybe a year and a half.
And I met a couple of other beauty gurus from his friends. Also, like yes. Brandon and
Cece. Yes, and for those, I guess I'll do a quick introduction of myself. My name is Rory. My handle on everything is Rory Long MUA. Like I just said, I've been doing makeup for about a year and a half. March 2019 is when I started. And yeah, so Anissa asked to be part of this video, and I would love to join.
Yeah, this is my first collab with a makeup artist. So,
and this is my first YouTube video, so first for all, yeah!
I'm going to do a fully look, and I'm recreating it from this person on Instagram. I don't know how to say her name, but I'll put the picture up. It's a blue... blue look like that.
Okay.
Without the gems.
Nice. So I am going to play with the Nikki Tutorials palette because I've only got to play with it once.
I am using the same one.
Great minds think alike.
Yeah. Dark blue in this one.
Yes.
And it's a blue from another palette.
Yes. So it's such a pretty palette, and pictures do not do it justice. Like all the shimmers on this, they look, I don't even know if I can get in there. They look so amazing. Throw them on the eyelid. Oh.
And I'm gonna mix a few blues from other palettes. This one, My Tubes Cosmetics.
Okay.
Like ooh. The two blues in this one. And I have like four palettes that I'm using blues in. So this one's ColourPop from Becky G.
Okay.
And I have like five of them I'm gonna use. This one is Dominique Cosmetics Celestial Thunder palette.
Oh, okay. I have that one. That's actually a really nice one.
Yeah. I like the blue one the most. I use the two blues the most. And gonna use the Pac-Man. Pac-Man Wild. It's broken. I had to tape it. And then this is blue purple color from Milani.
Okay.
I'm gonna use those blues. All of them, hopefully. Because I don't have a blue palette with only blue in it.
Nice. It's a good range of hues and shades on there. I don't know what exactly I'm going to do with this, but we will use this. I think I'm going to play on the lighter side. Do with some pinks and probably use that red because that red is beautiful and like a, it's like a true matte red. So it's the shade Mika.
Yeah, it's matte. I use that one a lot.
Yeah.
Because I don't have a light red in any palettes that are like that one.
Right.
It's like orangish a little bit. Has a little bit of orange in it. And purple.
Yeah.
I had to bring my piano bench to sit on.
That's right. You are like multi-talented. Like you do a lot of different stuff. I'm very impressed. It's like you write, you play piano.
Yeah, and I do makeup and sing a little bit.
Yeah.
My voice needs a little bit of tuning.
Nice. Don't mind me, I'm just reaching for my sponges. They have everything all in drawers. I've been trying to actually keep myself staying organized, and it's been working pretty far. My makeup table is not a mess. It also helps that it's also my computer desk. I have to switch between the two a lot.
I don't have a vanity. I keep mine on the floor in my room. And bins.
So I started in bins. I had like a 3-tier shelf that I bought from like Walmart or something. And then I kept buying makeup, and then I kept buying more makeup. And yeah, so it just kept on growing. So now I've like upgraded to this IKEA situation. I have some Alex drawers, which is really nice.
Yeah, I use a bins that are like the hairdressers mostly.
Okay.
But they're broken now because I have a lot of makeup on it. In it that the shelf part just kind of come off.
Yeah. Okay. So, do you use a base?
Yeah, I'm using my concealer from Vince.
Yes, so I'm going in with P. Louise. It's an eye base.
Is it better than concealer?
It might actually technically be a concealer. It's just, it's what I use. It's about, like, I could also use it to like kind of match my skin tone if I just wanted to do something more like natural looking makeup. But I find that it helps keep colors like truer, because you could always use like white and stuff, but white, especially on lighter colors, will bleed through and kind of brighten it. Like on reds, it'll make it pink.
Yeah, and like so, black will be gray more.
Yeah, so that's why I like using something that's more like closer to my skin tone, because then it helps keep the colors the same.
And white and the colors will stay in your eyelids, I think.
Yeah. So I'm lucky enough, I think I've only ever had a problem with staining once, and I think that's because I forgot to put a base down. Like, generally, from my experience, if you put a base down beforehand, you'll have less of a problem with staining, because it creates that barrier between your skin and the makeup. Okay.
Before, I didn't have any skin products, so I started like doing makeup without skin prep for years.
Same.
Like clogging my pores, that's what I heard it does.
Yep. And then like one of the best tips I ever heard was that like because your skin is your base, and if you want to have a good makeup application, you need to make sure you have skincare routine.
Yeah.
Or do some form of skincare. Because if your skin's crap, the makeup's not going to adhere to it, and it's just always gonna not look as well as it could.
I've deleted some of my old pics, but the progress was like I can see the powder through the makeup.
Yeah.
And on camera, I can see like underneath, I can see the powder more than my skin.
Oh yeah, you could see, especially in some of my early pictures, which I have all of mine up. I just kind of figured like, what's the point of deleting my older stuff, because like, you know, there was a journey going on. So yeah. It's nice to have people like see that, because I know a lot of people like, I could never, like from what I've seen is people like, I can never do makeup. Like you can, like, yeah, you can. You just gotta practice with it. Because I didn't start off well. I show them my first picture, which if you look on my Instagram, it's there, not posted. I didn't post that as my first picture, but as a comparison, it's not just for 6 months. You can, there's a difference.
I actually keep my old pictures like in a, I started off with a makeup account.
Yeah.
I keep my old pictures in that makeup account, and then I started making new ones. So I tag myself in both of them to make it look like I have features.
Okay.
Because people get featured a lot. My goal is to get on the Explore page.
That's everyone's goal. Right now it's so hard with the hashtags still being down from the election.
Yeah.
don't know. But there's other ways. Like, I've been posting some stuff on Twitter, and I've noticed people following that. I don't know. Twitter and TikTok seem to be the two easiest to gain followers on. Instagram, it's like dang near impossible.
Yeah. Instagram is, you just have to keep up with the content, like other people's content.
Yeah.
And the trends. I think Instagram is mostly on trends.
So I'm actually going to start with Micah and put that on the outer corner. Or Mikai, I'm sorry, not Micah.
That's Nikki, younger brother?
Yeah, that was her younger brother that passed away. And she named it after.
Oh, I forgot to show. I'm using the Pac-Man light blue.
Okay.
I'm mixing it.
Oh, dang. Forgot to do brows. We gotta fix that. I don't do too much to my brows. Literally, all I do is just throw a tinted brow gel on.
And I'm mixing it with this dark blue.
Nice.
I'm trying to get that transition to the lightest to darkest, like how she has her look in the picture.
Yeah. So this is just a Mellow Cosmetics tinted brow gel in what's this dark brown. I just kind of comb it through just to help define my brows a little bit more. There we go. That looks better.
So are you going to make a YouTube channel?
Yes, I am going to. I am finally in a spot where I think that I can do it. I'm going to try to record because I have the Raw Beauty Christie ColourPop collab coming. And I'm going to try and actually record that and do a YouTube video. If it gets here by Friday, I can record on it because I have to go back to work on Saturday. Because right now I am currently in quarantine because my partner unfortunately has corona. He's doing well. He's just kind of coughing right now and just kind of lethargic. But other than that, nothing's, his symptoms haven't gotten worse. So we're really lucky about that. But because of that, I work in the food service industry, so I can't be around them because I could literally catch it any day. I've tested negative twice. I've got another test on the way. So hopefully I luck out and don't get it, but it's that possibility. So right now work has me on quarantine because of that. So I'm using this time to actually work on makeup and content and stuff like that.
Yeah, you should use any type of time you have.
What was that?
Like you can use any time you have that's free.
Yeah. Because normally I'm working 3 p.m. like I told you when we were trying to get this together before all this. I was working 3 p.m. to 1 a.m. Monday through Friday, so that's 50 hours. Plus I have an hour drive to and from work, so that's 12 hours a day.
Yeah.
And that's if I get out and work on time. So it's been hectic, but I am making the best of the situation.
I'm currently not in working, but I applied for a Walmart job.
Yeah.
Haven't heard anything from them yet.
Yeah.
But I want to get a job before my birthday.
When's your birthday?
January 16th.
Oh. It'd be surprising if Walmart isn't hiring.
Yeah,
especially with the holiday season coming up, although it'll be interesting because of social distancing guidelines.
Yeah. And I'm almost finished with college.
Nice.
I have one more semester.
What are you in college for?
Journalism.
Oh, cool. That makes sense.
Yeah. We're talent of mine, I guess. Journalism is like gonna be writing for magazines and articles, like opinion articles and stuff for entertainment industry. And
looking, well, I wish you luck with that.
I'm looking for the intern job right now.
Okay.
I'm using the Milani palette. I'm going to use the color Bewitched, this dark blue.
Okay.
And I'm using the light green blue color from Becky palette.
Now on the middle third of my eye, I'm going in with the shade Redemption. And we're just going to build that up. So what I like to do when I'm doing looks like this, I'm going to pack each color on the eye. And then once I do that, then I'll blend in between the like where the colors meet. So then that way you get that like trans... Ooh, I put that in the wrong part. Oh, well. So then you get that transition, so it looks like it's like fading from one color to another.
Yeah.
So what is your favorite, what's your favorite makeup company? We'll go with that question.
My makeup company, like a brand?
Yeah, favorite brand.
Right now I'll say Rare.
Okay, so you actually use the Rare products?
Yeah, I'm using the, I only have the palette right now. It's called like Magnetic Energy or something.
And okay.
I haven't yet ever seen it because I have a lot of responsibilities to pay for. But I'll get like the foundation stuff later.
Nice. I'm definitely interested in that. I just haven't gone and ordered it yet.
And I really want to try Fenty.
The only product from Fenty I've tried is their cream bronzer, but I love it. It's actually one of my staples on my base. So we'll see that in a little bit.
Okay. And Charlotte Tilbury, I want to try their bronzer. I might get a few high-end products because I need some for my graduation picture. I want to be off glam.
Nice. Okay. Now on this last third, the inner third of my eye, I'm going with Vila. This is a yellow shade. So we've used Mikai, Redemption, and now Vila, which is having a hard time showing up. Okay, so we're gonna build this up.
Have you tried Brandon's highlighter?
Oh yeah, I have Brandon's highlighter literally right here.
Wow, I want to buy it. I just don't have the money right now.
No, it's, if you ever get the chance to try out CXC, definitely go for it. Their stuff is freaking amazing. So this is what the palette looks like.
Wow. Is a purple like actually the color?
Here, I'll swatch it on my hand.
Wow.
It's actually it's
brown.
What?
It looks like it's a brown shade.
Yeah, it comes out purple, but it's meant definitely for deeper skin tones. But I'll still throw purple on my face because I don't care. You give me a color, I'm gonna throw it on my face and make it look good.
I'm going to use the palette, the Nikki palette, and I'm using the dark blue in the outer corner.
Nice. Well, that's Amsterdam, isn't it? Yes.
I use one brush for the same, for everything. It's only when I'm doing like one color look.
Yeah.
That's just a waste of time to switch brushes. I'm gonna try to wing it out, like towards the arch of my brow.
Excuse me. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna pack on just a little bit more of that Vila.
When is the first time you ever played with makeup?
The first time I ever played with makeup was... Where did I put my phone? Oh, it fell. March, it honestly, truly was, it was the middle of March 2019. It was like, I'll find the picture. Yeah, but it was, yeah, like I've been wanting to for a while, and I like, I slowly like built some stuff, and then finally I like pulled the trigger. I went and did a like Target haul to Elf. And I spent like $100 just to get like a full face of everything, which is funny because I was like, it's so much money, and now here I am, and I'm, you know, dropping palettes that are not worth $100, but like I can easily spend $100 and I have like only 3 items.
I can't do that. Like I would have to like buy everything separately, like wait a few weeks until I get the money and then buy the product.
Yeah, I mean, I recognize that I'm fortunate enough to be able to do that because my job does pay actually a decent money, and you know, I get all my bills paid and I have stuff left over at the end of the month. So like, I recognize that I'm lucky in that aspect.
When I want to get a job so that I can start spending $100 on stuff.
Where is that picture? There we go.
Also, you can send it to me so I can put it in the video if you want.
Okay. Yeah, we can do that. You can just pop it up. Be like, first time somewhere. I don't know where it'll be on the video, but somewhere in the video, you'll get to see my first makeup look. It's horrifying.
My first review was the Kylie Cosmetics review.
Nice.
And I didn't know what US dollars was at the time, so I spent like $99 on the holiday 2016 palette. Yeah. Not like, I think it was like 40 something US.
Dang. Okay, so now I'm actually gonna go in and blend Redemption in Vila. So a trick that I like to do when blending is I'll take my brush, and then I dip once in each shade that's gonna blend together just to help start mixing them. And then we just go in, merge those two sides together just to help create that like seamless fade. Okay.
Today I was trying to apply for a community number. Have enough support, so do it. So I'm trying to get, like, they texted me and asking me like what what's my brand.
Yeah.
I just tell them like a small paragraph of all my socials with how much followers I have. I don't think I'm looking for it, but I can't really explain what my brand is right now. I mean, this morning I put my real number on my bio just because I was bored, but I deleted it.
I was about to say, that's, you want to make sure you're being careful with stuff like that.
Yeah.
So, because there is some, you know, the internet is an interesting place for sure.
I mean, some people have their actual number on for like business.
Well, that's true. Oh, case by case basis, I guess. I guess as long as you're comfortable handling out there, then that's all that matters.
But like, I would rather pay for a community number than my real phone number.
Yeah. Okay.
It's privacy. Are you with any other brands like on Instagram, like as an ambassador?
So I am a brand ambassador for Elsewhere Cosmetics. They are a Black-owned indie company based out of San Antonio, Texas. They are, the owner is freaking amazing. Her and I talk all the time. She's one of like the nicest people I've ever met. We actually are in the middle of promoting for our Black Friday. What's today? The 16th. Okay, so today the new Manifest palette is revealed. So if you go on Elsewhere's page, I don't know if it's up exactly yet, but sometime today it will be up. The Manifest palette that is launching on Black Friday, as well as 7 styles of lashes. I think it was 7. But then there's also some big sales. All of her other palettes are on sale for 35% off on Black Friday. And then also, if you were to use my code RORY10, that's RORY10, you can save 10% off. And then I actually do get a little bit of a kickback from that. Just so, you know, full transparency going into that, if you were to use that, I get something from it. But no pressure to use the code. You don't have to. Or if you find someone else's code, you can use that too. And then I am also... actually, here, we'll stay with Elsewhere for a quick moment while I have half an eye on. Because I have all their palettes right here. So I'll just kind of show them off. And here's the third one. So this was Elsewhere's Pride palette this year. Colorful Rainbow Story. It's got a lot of mattes and then different shades of each color with glitters of each one, plus a black and a white, because you can't go wrong with those. And then you have Elsewhere's first palette. They launched this Black Friday of last year. This is the Damn It's Cold palette. It's a 9-pan palette based on the winter time of Texas. It's got some beautiful shades. This one right here is like a glittery blue shift, very hard to see. And then their newest palette that they just launched is the Alexander palette. This was actually made by Millie's brother, and he chose all the shades and he based it on the Harlem Renaissance. It's an amazing color story. It's got like purples and teals. Got some purple glitter. Like got some black. What?
I like the lavender purple.
Yes, flapper right here.
Yeah,
it's great. So those are some of their palettes. And like I said, all these are actually going to be on sale Black Friday, 35% off. Or is it 30? I think it was 30. And then another brand that I am affiliated with is the brand CXC Beauty. They're a little bit more higher end when it comes to price. But they have, like, if you want, you're looking for a monochromatic palette, this beginning of the year, they did a monochromatic series. So they literally have, like, every color in the rainbow in a palette. Here's one of my favorites, the Red Queen palette. And then, like, I've used this and dropped it, but, you know, here's what that looks like, Red Queen. And I do have a code with them as well. That's just code Rory, R-O-R-Y, and that you save 15%. But if it is your first time purchasing with them, you can use the code CXCSQUAD and save 20% off your first purchase. And then you can use my code. I don't have any kickback for that code, so you can use that and don't have to worry about me getting anything or not. But yeah, so those are the two brands that I'm, like, actually affiliated with and that I, like, talk to the owners on a regular basis. Okay, so now we're going to duplicate this color over to this side. So what got you into makeup?
I started it in high school.
Okay.
And at first I wanted to just copy looks from celebrities. Then I started liking it for myself. And when I started actually having my own money, that's when I started buying makeup. Before, I was in love with makeup, but I didn't have money to buy any.
Yeah.
And I know that if I ask my dad to buy for money, that will not happen. Or my mom. So I waited until I had money to buy makeup, and then that's when I started falling in love with it.
Okay.
Do you do your lower lash line before foundation or after?
It honestly depends on my mood. Sometimes I'll do foundation, then I'll do lower lash line. Other times I do lower lash line and then foundation. This time I'm actually probably going to do foundation before I do lower lash line and get all that stuff.
Yeah. I do mine after. I do mine last, like when I have my full base on and my lashes on. But I don't wear fake lashes.
Have you ever tried fake lashes?
Yeah, but they didn't stick well. Like, they just keep falling off. And I had my friend do it for me, but they kept falling off.
Okay. I remember when I first started, I was so afraid of lashes. I was like, they don't work. And then I just kept on, like, trying. And then eventually they worked, and now I can't do a look without them. I'm like, what is wrong? Why does my face look weird? And I'm like, I don't have lashes on. Let's fix that.
And I would rather spend, like, $50 on a palette instead of eyelashes and glue, mostly, my opinion.
Everyone's allowed to their own opinion. There's no wrong way to do makeup.
My own lashes and body. Other lashes put on. But I know they changed the look to another level. As my friends have a eyelash brand.
Yeah.
And she has her own business now. And she makes clip-on nails.
Ooh.
And she has some eyelashes. I'll put it in the description. And my friend Taylor, she's a makeup artist. And she has a degree in makeup from school. And she has her own website now. She's selling, like, lashes and makeup and stuff like that.
Nice. That's cool. I always like it when people are able to do stuff like that. You know, I'm like, how are we feeling about this? Oh yeah. Okay, now we just gotta blend these colors out.
I have a question.
Yeah.
Do you think having like baby's photos of makeup as your client makeup is like on a website good?
Like what?
Like I do makeup on my cousins for practice, like my baby cousins and stuff like that, and I use them as client makeup photos. Like if I have it on a website or something, is that like good or bad?
I think if you, the only thing I'm thinking of is that if you're going to put, especially when it comes to minors, if you're going to put them out on the internet, that you need to have just parents' permission that it's okay.
Yeah.
That's my only thought when it comes to like, you know, I mean, and generally like when people set up clients and stuff doing that, there's always like, if they're going to like, potentially put them on the internet, they should be filling out like a form like, hey, I'm gonna take a picture of this, the picture's gonna go on the internet, yada yada yada, kind of thing. So as long as like the person knows and they have that consent, then I don't see a problem with it. But just, and especially for minors, making sure they have their parents' consent,
because I didn't consent, but they said it's all right, they don't care,
then that's fine.
Because I only have it on Instagram.
Yeah. Yeah, and that's just thinking like as a business at that point, because when you're like, when you were to start doing it as a freelance artist, you are a business. So then it's just kind of one of those things that you'd be thinking of like in the terms of you as a business and not you as a person, like having it on a personal account for fun and stuff. That's, you know, but like as a business account or like, as a business, you want to make sure you're doing stuff like by the book in case, you know, for legal purposes.
I mean, the personal account is starting to become a business account, I guess.
Yeah. Like,
I'm going to use my own content, but I only have them on a highlight. Like, it's not on the actual page.
Yeah. And with them being family, it's a little bit different and stuff like that. I was just thinking like in terms of in general.
No, it's just family members, my cousins.
Yeah,
and that's the only pictures I have.
I'm just gonna go in with some cotton ball and micellar water just to kind of. The yellow got a little too far down from what I'd like, and I don't want it to mix in with my foundation when I apply that.
Yeah, foundation on already?
No, not yet. But I don't want to like mix the yellow with my foundation when I get there.
Oh.
Okay. Normally I would use a Q-tip, but I don't have any Q-tips near me.
Oh.
Because Q-tip, you can get a more precise point, but cotton ball works just as fine. Okay. Now we gotta cut this crease. I was looking for you yesterday. Where did you disappear to? I was looking for this little flat top brush?
I am going to clean up the edges with some concealer. I can get it. I've never done like makeup on Zoom before.
I haven't either. This is my first time.
Yeah. I don't know how the editing is gonna go.
I'm sure you'll figure it out.
I'm trying to have it done by Saturday. Because I post on Saturdays. Yeah. And I have other pre-recorded videos already to edit.
Cutting the crease is always one of the hardest parts because you gotta be so meticulous.
That has to be precise.
I'm sorry, one more time.
When doing the cut crease, it has to be precise.
Yeah. For me. Well, I also have to be careful because I have like droopy eye part right here and lid, so like it'll transfer up and then I have to make it even bigger, so I have to make sure that I keep my eyes open and arch my brows during the whole process.
Surprisingly, I have a lot of eye space. My lid is big. Look at creases.
Yeah. So I'm jealous of people that have the lid space.
I can take it as high as I want. So do you know if like artists can replicate makeup looks? Like actual artists?
Like what do you mean actual artists?
Like pen and paper, like.
Oh, I'm sure they could.
Yeah.
Like are you talking about like could they do their own makeup and replicate, or are you talking about like if they were painting someone on paper?
Like if they can, I see people like they draw like celebrities and they do the exact same makeup on paper.
Yeah.
But I'm wondering if
they... I mean, I think like it transferred on paper because it's essentially copying color. Mm-hmm. Which is, you know, that's just what they do when they make artwork in general. It's, you know, they take colors and there's blending and shade gradients and all that stuff. So I think it'd be fairly easy for them to replicate it onto paper. Now, could they do it on their own face with makeup? Who knows? That's a different type of skill set.
And they take it to their arms. They can do it on their arms that I see on Instagram.
Oh, yeah. No, that makes sense. Because on the arm, it's so much easier than you get a little bit more control. Okay. So we got this crease cut. You're going to make me
I don't even know why I tried to do a smaller cut crease.
So far, in Nikki's palette, the most cut crease colors I use is Pride and Aurora.
And which one?
The colors I mostly use is Pride, Aurora.
Oh, okay, I see it.
And Roxy Catan.
Nice. Oh, so I'm actually going to go in with Pride.
Yeah.
So, which is like this like pinky shift color. I'm telling you though, on camera it does not do this justice at all. It's such a beautiful shade.
Maybe flash and I do it in the dark. That's what I do. It might show on camera.
Nice. I'll remember that if I ever actually get around to taking product shots of anything. No, I'm like trying to get my space cleared up. Like I've got over here, I've got this little six drawer desk, or not dress. I can't speak. Six drawer cabinet thing. Where it's, what are they? That I actually got some stuff I could use to do a nice little, like, proper product shot area, but I gotta get some stuff off of it. I also have some shelves that I need to install on the walls over here, and I might do, like, I might do two above me and just do one over here, because I got three of them. Then I can get some little stuff up there. This is, like, my little personal area.
I really want to do shelves on the wall, but my dad's like, nobody does that.
Yeah.
I want to do it for storage space. Because I use my dresser has a lot of stuff I want to put, like, on display.
Yeah. No, I just got to get a stud finder, which we have one, but the one that we're borrowing, we don't know if it's actually working or not, so we need to get another one. And then otherwise I'd have them up already. There we go.
So for my mom's downstairs, and she didn't notice I took the bench. I mean, if she goes in my room, then she'll notice.
Well, it's just for a little bit. She'll be fine.
Yeah. I'll usually wait until she's back upstairs to put it back downstairs.
Okay. I just gotta bring this down a little bit.
But have you tried any Ariana's makeup from the past, like Viva Glam?
No, I didn't even know that she had, like, was it like a collab with MAC?
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't even know she had that, but if that was before 2019, then I definitely haven't tried it.
I'm thinking of doing a makeup video.
Yeah.
All my idols' makeup. Because I have Camila Cabello's makeup and Ariana. I just need to get Selena's makeup. And then I'll do the video.
Nice. One second, I'm gonna stare at my face.
Okay, so then we just gotta bring this up.
A little too thin now.
Okay, so now the crease is cut. Let's throw. I'm gonna throw pride on there. There's a little pack of brush. Ah, there we go. Actually, we're gonna use the finger. Oh my gosh, that is so soft. There we go.
Your finger for that color?
Yeah, it packs on a lot better. So I'll use a finger for most of it, and then I use a brush just to kind of get it onto like the top corners that are hard to reach. And then I don't get as much control with. Okay, now we'll go with this, just kind of bring pride out.
I'm going to keep blending the colors.
So hmm?
I'm going to keep using the same colors until I get it to look the way I want.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to try to get as close to the picture as possible.
Okay, there we go. Oh my gosh, this color is brilliant. Okay, there we go. Got most of that on with my eyelid. Now we just gotta bring it out to the wing.
Getting there.
Hmm?
Getting there.
Some more of that micellar water to get the everything off my hands. Like, I know hands get messy when you do it, you put stuff on, but like, I hate my hands being messy.
Yeah.
So as soon as I'm able to, I like rubbing all the makeup off. Okay. Okay, and one thing I'm now going to do. I'm just going to bring these colors up. I should have done these first, but oh well. I'm going to bring these up. And kind of blend this more. There we go. Just for the brown one. Okay, and then now we are going to bring that up a little bit over here. There we go. And where'd that brush go? Okay, we're just gonna tap a little bit of ivy for a brow bone highlight. Just gonna lightly pack that on just to give a little bit of dimension. If it wants, there we go.
Ah. Grabbing something.
Okay. I will be here.
The other box.
Okay, so I'll actually be right back because I didn't forget to wet my beauty sponge. So I'll be just gonna be 2 seconds.
Okay. I am going to use the Suva liquid eyeshadow. And I'm going to do a wing liner in my setting spray.
Okay, and I am back. Which one's the right side? Okay. There we go.
Using a liquid blue eyeshadow for eyeliner.
Nice. Thank you.
to me. I'm just hoping I don't repeat history. Boy, I'm trying to meet your mama on Sunday.
No, please let it try.
You good if I go on to do my bass, or do you want me to wait?
You can start.
Okay. So I'm going to start with my favorite, the Elf Poreless Putty Primer. You can tell it's my favorite because it's like pretty much empty. I'm just going to go some of that. Put that on. So, like, I love creating eye looks because, you know, there's so much fun and colorful and stuff. But doing my face is a different type of fun. And I kind of might enjoy it more. I have no idea why.
Like, waiting for the finish. Look to see how you look.
Yeah, that's true, because especially face like contouring and all that just changes your face so much.
Like, you look like yourself, but you also don't.
Right. I was saying, I have I don't know what to call it, like androgynous face or something like that. Like, I mean, obviously right now, especially because I got this little thing going on, since I'm in quarantine, might as well. You know, I present more masculine, but like when I do makeup, I definitely look more feminine, and it's interesting. Not that it matters anyway to me, because I look how I look.
Yeah, it doesn't matter at all.
Okay, so I'm gonna go in with my Holy Grail foundation, the Urban Decay Stay Naked. Just can't speak. The Urban Decay Stay Naked Liquid Foundation, which this is like, yes. I love this foundation. Ever since I tried it when it first came out last summer, or like summer 2019. And I was like, okay, I need to try that. And I did, and I fell in love with it. And like, I got my perfect shade the first time, at least for the time. Oh, that was actually, it's still now. This is 30 NN. It has like different, it has like, they have it set up to where like this is, so you have, you know, the 30 is the like shade intensity, and then you've got your master undertone and then your undertone. It's like I'm a true neutral.
I'm using my Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara. I did my mascara first before my base, because I think I will forget about my mascara if I do it at the very end.
I do mascara right before I do lashes. Okay. I'm gonna take a tiny dot of this.
I'm gonna do my base now.
Okay. Here, take out earrings while I do the base.
I'm using Maybelline Fit Me Foundation in shade 356 Warm Coconut. I realize like I've been using the wrong shade for months, and I still love that shade because I've been using the deep side instead of the warm side.
Ah.
And I didn't know there was a difference between warm and deep.
Oh, it's so hard to find your right shade though. Yeah. Especially like right now, since
we can't go and do use testers and stuff to like test out, which, you know, like I understand, but still sucks when you're like, I really want to find my shade. So you just do a lot of trial and error. There is a website called Find Nation. Mm-hmm. I think it's Find Nation. It helps you like you pick what your colors are and like the foundations, you know, and then it'll tell you like, okay, hey, if you're like, then the more matches you put in there, the like more specific it gets. Like, hey, if you're this and this, this and this, then if you were trying to go with this foundation, you would be this shade. And for the most part, it's accurate, I find.
What I really, really want to try is Il Maquillage. If you heard of that brand.
Mm-hmm.
And their color is pretty much accurate to your actual skin tone.
Yeah, like, because what it is like, so you have your foundations that you know your shade of, like, these are your matte shades. So what it does is it says, okay, so if you're this and this, it's a database and it compares them and says, okay, so if you're using these three foundations, these are your shades for each of them, then that would equal out to this foundation in whatever brand you were looking for.
Some foundations have the same shade name.
No, not every foundation does. Like, some like do it. They kind of each, there's no like universally accepted system. And then like some do it to where, you know, most go from like the lowest numbers, the lightest shade, up until the highest numbers, the darkest shade. But I know like Juvia's Place, they flip that around. So like the lower the number, the darker the shade. That's why having a website like that is helpful. Just so then you can like, go in with a better idea. Or even figuring out like what your undertones are. That helps too. Because some people can have the right shade, but they might have the right undertone. And then that'll also be causing them to like look orange or things like that. So like I have neutral undertones. So I get foundations that go in with neutral.
I heard a long time ago that if I have green or blue veins, then I'm a golden undertone.
I've heard something like that, but I can't remember.
I always run out of foundation when I'm going to my forehead. I mean, these Maple Leaf Fitmes really do need a pump because you ran out of the whole bottle so fast.
Yeah. I feel like most foundations should come with a pump. Like, why wouldn't you?
It makes you save more.
Exactly. Like, I know that I have the Estee Lauder Double Wear Foundation. I got that. And that didn't come without a pump. And I was like, what? And then they want you to buy the pump for like $10.
Seriously?
Yeah. It's like, why isn't the pump standard? Like, on one hand, though, like, it does kind of make it more environmentally friendly because you just use the same pump and switch it out. Just make sure you clean it if it's not the same shade. But, like, on the other hand, convenient. Okay.
I mean, in some brands, they do. It makes sense because right now, this shampoo brand that I follow, mm-hmm, I'm thinking of emailing them and letting them know that they should have extra pumps on sale for separate. Just because their pumps that like, isn't, they don't work or they break, and you can't screw it back on.
I just realized that this is off. Why is this off?
It's like a little request I make, and sometimes they listen. I'm not sure what to do about my pre-picture. So I'm gonna use the foundation and I'm gonna cover it up with foundation.
Okay, so now I'm going to go in with the Urban Decay Stay Naked Correcting Concealer. So I'm actually going to go in with the shade 20NN, because I have two types. I have 30NN when I don't necessarily want to like highlight areas, but since I have my studio lighting, I will highlight because it'll look better. But then this is 30NN my shade when I'm like just kind of wearing out and want it to look, you know, good in natural lighting versus studio lighting. But since I'm not, I'm going to go in with the 20NN, which is just the shade lighter. I'm not going to go too crazy. I'm just going to go a little bit.
You have a winter shade and a summer shade?
Hmm?
You have a winter shade and a summer shade?
Not necessarily. So it is more, it's like you can use concealers. This looks crazy. It'll look better in a moment. You can use concealers to help highlight areas. So like, you know, when people do the triangles underneath and then like up here and the nose and that just helps highlight and brighten areas. And for like type of makeup that looks good in studio lighting. Like a lot of YouTubers and Instagrammers were doing this for the longest time. They've kind of gone away from that. Because, you know, so now it's like a little less. I am going to fully embrace it today though. Because there is nothing wrong with that if that's what you want. And today, that's what I want. So just gonna bring that up. Just highlight those high points. Bring that down.
Using the Essence Camouflage Concealer. It's like $2.
Essence is such a good brand. They are so underrated.
Yeah.
Like their Lash Princess mascara, it's like $5 and it's the best thing out there.
I guess it's because they're cheap. I mean, like the cheap. Do you put it at the back of the corner of the store?
Yeah.
Basically, where no one goes to. And they put all the high end stuff at the front.
I mean, yeah. Okay, so now I'm gonna just highlight the nose. Put this up. Gonna blend this out. Okay. Then we're just gonna put a little bit right here.
I'm trying to decide like if I should contour or bronze. I don't do both sometimes.
I just contour, but I use a bronzer as a contour, which I know is a little weird, but
yeah. I mean, it depends on the different skin tones. That's why other people use it differently. I am just going to contour instead of bronze. Because I heard my friend told me that I don't have to do both.
No, you don't have to. Generally, you do like full everything when you're going like full glam. That's when you do like everything.
Okay, so now we're gonna set this with, we've got some kimchi puff puff pass set in bake powder.
I'm using Slay Cosmetics contour palette. I'm almost done.
Love it when you hit pan on a product.
I love it when people show the pan in the videos.
Right. Oh, sorry, I hit on my Fenty cream bronzer. I just hit pan.
Yeah.
So right there.
Those are
your favorite.
The first time I heard about this was I bought it from Elta.com.
Okay. I don't know why I closed that up without putting the pump back in. There we go.
I'm just gonna knock over a bottle because why not? Okay, I'm just gonna get all this excess off. There we go.
Okay. Now it is contour time. Yes.
Feels like to do that we're on the same
page. Hmm?
I said it's nice that we're on the same page.
Yes.
We might okay. Finish on time, but at the same time.
Like I just showed, I'm going in with the Fenty, it's the Cheeks Out Freestyle Cream Bronzer. This is the shade Macchiato. So then what I do is I get some, I use a brush to apply it and then a sponge to blend it out. So I get some on a contour brush. Go about halfway up and then bring up to the end of my sideburns. On the same side. Okay. And then I will put some here and here on my forehead.
Now I'm going to do some blush, and I Sailor Moon blush.
How is that?
Really nice. The shimmer doesn't really show as much, but it shows a little bit, like in the light. You can see it.
Yeah.
Like the more you apply, the more it will show.
That makes sense.
Come here as well. Take this off quick.
I'm not gonna lie, the palette disappointed me.
Same. But why?
So I'm a total nerd. I like grew up watching Sailor Moon. I mean, you can see I've got a Madoka Magica poster right over here. That I didn't realize you could see. But hey, whatever. And so like I grew up with Sailor Moon and stuff, and then they re-released it with a new dub and everything, so it wasn't edited and it was pure to the original and all that stuff. And just the names for the palette and the color story. So like when I hear a Sailor Moon palette, I'm gonna think something colorful. I'm gonna think of something that like comprises up all the Sailor Scouts, like something like that, and it was very much not that. And then the names just did not make any sense to me. Like literally my friend and I, we like were watching some reviews on it, looked at it, and we're like, what is with these names? And then we just out the top of our head came up with 12 names that worked. like, so her transformation phrase is Moon Prism Power Makeup. Literally top line right there should have been Moon Prism Power Makeup. Bam. So like, it's little stuff like that. Like, I haven't, you know, I didn't get it, so I don't know about the quality of the shade. I mean, it's a ColourPop palette. I've only ever played with one ColourPop palette, but just that, it just was kind of a mess for me. Everything else of it was fine, but I just feel like the palette and the names just were not, it was just someone that knew it was Sailor Moon, not someone that knew Sailor Moon. Like, if that makes sense, like, they didn't know anything about it, they've never watched it. They're just like, oh, we got the license to it, so we're gonna just throw some names on there and stuff. And like, if I'm gonna get something related to that, especially that people have a lot of nostalgia for, I would want it done right and like effective. Or like, even if they did like a phase two that then included the Sailor Scouts or something, but it doesn't seem like that's the case. I could be wrong. But even then, I just feel like there weren't enough pinks in the palette, even if it was just specifically Sailor Moon herself.
I think it just represents ColourPop instead of the actual show.
Yes, it's very much ColourPop with Sailor Moon packaging.
Yeah.
Versus, like, their Disney stuff makes sense with each princess and all that. Like, looking at all their, like, character collabs, it all makes sense.
And it makes me want to buy them all.
Yes. Okay, gotta take this out while we blend the contour under here to make it look like I have a doll.
Like the Cheeto makeup, for example.
What?
The Cheetos makeup. Like, nah. They don't even have all the shades of orange.
All it makes me think of is Coco Montrese from season 5 of Drag Race. Girl, look how orange you look.
And some stores shouldn't even start with makeup, like Forever 21.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that was weird. I don't even know why they got it. Well, like, and that, did you, like, yeah, I don't know why you would. Well, I mean, they would because they want to make money. And, you know, you can do what you can to make money.
Mm. But, like, they don't know anything about makeup. No one's going to go to a clothing store to buy makeup.
Well, some people did, apparently. Oh. So next we're going to go with blush.
I'm going to do my brows now. And then do my highlight and the lip.
Oh, there it is. Okay, so I'm going to be using the CXC Beauty Beyond Blush palette, Ivy's Kiss, and I'm going to be going into shade Dusty Rose, which is the shade right here.
That palette's really pretty.
It is. They have three blush palettes, and they are all so pigmented, but, like, amazing. Like, yeah. I love the shade. And, like, this is, like, when I apply this out, this looks like my face when I don't have makeup on. So it's perfect.
I'm gonna grab some. So I'm gonna use Morphe Jeffree Star palette for my brows.
Oh, are you using,
I'm using the dark brown.
Yeah.
Eyeshadow. I don't have anything like for brows. I mean, I do, but they're old.
Look at that. Yeah.
It's like a nice sheen.
Like, just like a hint of pink, but not like overbearing. Which, I mean, trust me, I will go with a very pink blush when the moment calls for it. But we're feeling a little subtle today. Okay. Oh my gosh, I forgot to contour my nose. I always forget that. Always.
Wow.
Like, I'll remember by the end of the look, but like I'll just be there. And then generally it's around the time for some reason I like blush and I look at my nose and I forget to contour my nose. So where is my nose contouring brush? There it is. Then same thing with the for nose contour. I use a nose contouring little angled brush, and then I just, you know, I'll go in and then apply my nose and buff it out with a beauty blender. Okay. I might have to reapply some concealer on that, and that is fine.
I wish I had blue lipstick.
Wish you had blue what? Do you have a white lipstick?
No. I just have like some nudes and
pink. So if you had a white, you can mix in some blue eyeshadow with it, and then it would make it blue. Okay, so I'm gonna blend this out, and I gotta just put a little bit. As I can see that back on my nose. Just a bit. Okay. Ah, there we go.
Okay, so
the makeup look. Now I'm just going to put concealer on here. Then we just gotta pop that out a little bit. For a lot of it. There we go. Bam.
That's the best of my eyebrows will look. I don't like to spend too much time on one thing.
Okay, now highlight.
I'm gonna do my lower lash line and then my highlight.
Yeah. Actually, that makes sense. I'll finish my eyes and then I'll do a highlight because I need to figure out what color I'm going to do. Look, wow, what color I'm going to do anyway. That is not the right drawer for blush.
Intro and outro when I'm done with my makeup look.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll show it to the camera and I'll do my montage.
Now for my lower lash line, like my under, I'm just literally bringing the colors down to each section, starting with Meat Pie, then Redemption, and now onto Vila.
I want to put just like a pop. I'm going to use Mama Tutorials.
Is it for an inner corner, just a pop of blue? So this little sparkly shade right here.
My dude.
We're going to go in here.
Pop her right in.
Yeah, it might be easier because people think he's
or I'm just gonna throw stuff everywhere.
Whatever works.
Okay.
And pop the same color on the inner corner.
You're looking for a specific brush. I cannot find it. And I'm knocking stuff over.
Ah, there. Okay. So if you have not, I highly, highly recommend getting like a little silicone brush like this. So this is for like pressed glitters. Or, and I guess we'll try it out and see if it works. Like, it'll help keep them on. So then you can kind of pack them on without losing the glitter anywhere. Yeah. So I'm actually using this for the Mama Tutorial shape. Just pack that color on right where I want it. Since these shimmers have a harder time wanting to stay on. Like brushes. Like the best application for this would be with your finger, but for the inner corner it's a little bit harder to do.
I'm thinking like something like this.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I will use the.
Wait, no, is that a? No, it's not. Is that like one of those foam ones?
Yeah.
No, this isn't a foam. This is like a silicone tip.
Oh.
Like, I've only seen a few places have them. It's like kind of like a newer style brush that's come out.
Yeah.
But I think Morphe has one. This is a Morphe brush. This is part of the Morphe Mitchell brush set. But I know that they have like a regular one and a few other places have, so I definitely recommend that if you use loose glitters or like shimmers that don't want to stick on the brush and only use a finger, you can use this well to help get into more precise places, because like fingers can be harder.
Now I'm doing my highlight. I'm done. I am using, it's called San Marcel Paris Luxurious Highlight Palette. My friend Juliana Maria sent it to me.
Nice.
And I'm using the shade Amour and Foila.
Nice.
They're very subtle. I like a sparkle, a shimmer to it. And I'm using this brush.
Okay, I'm applying some mascara. I'm applying, this is it's a mini trial version of Urban Decay's Perversion mascara. Which I really like. I probably will pick up a full size of this when I run out. Or I'll go on to something else. I hate using my non-dominant hand to do this. Why am I doing this to myself? There we go.
Nice and subtle.
Okay. Lashes.
But I just put pink water in my setting spray bottle.
I'm gonna go in with these lashes. These are Lavender Boutique lashes in the style Eva. And let's hope that I'm gonna have a good lash day. And then for lash glue, I've actually got the Kiss Lash Glue Liner. And then I'm actually just gonna apply it directly to the lash. I'm not gonna. I'm not gonna apply it as a liner because it's just white and I don't want to like muddy up the colors I already have on there.
Lips. I'm using this one from Pop Sugar Beauty. It's just a nude lip crayon that matches my lip color. Gonna show my look to the camera and do my montage.
Oh my gosh. Lashes are not wanting to work today. Come on, lashes. Work with me here. There we go. Lashes. Love-hate relationship with them. Come on. Why are you being like this?
lashes.
Kind
of looked like a picture, but more curved. Yeah.
Straight.
There we go. Yay!
The artist is EVYXO_ on Instagram. I'm just hoping I don't repeat history.
Boy, I'm trying to meet your mama on Sunday. Okay, now I just need a highlight and a lip. So for highlight.
Community just texted. They said it's perfect, so I guess
what?
They say my brand is perfect and that I'll enjoy the community.
Nice.
Watch a video to see how it works. I'll do that after.
Congrats.
So hopefully, I don't have money for it. I'm not sure how much it's gonna cost, but hopefully I'll be able to get it next month. If they don't reject me by then, because I think you have to do it right away before they forget.
I think I'm actually gonna use this Milk holographic highlighter. In the shade Supernova.
Instagram story with you after? Do you mind if I do an Instagram story with you after?
No. Okay. Then we got that blended out now. And then for the lip, I'm going to use the CXC Beauty Liquid Lip in the shade Icon. It's like a nudie purple. Bitch.
Okay, I'm gonna let this dry for a moment. Nice, nice setting spray.
Gonna use the kimchi stage proof matte setting spray.
And finally,
dry it off.
Extra.
That's the only way I know how to be.
Yeah.
Oh,
I use my mirror.
Hey, whatever works.
Yeah.
Okay, there we go. But anyway, so yes. So here's the completed look. I'm
gonna bow.
I guess we're both finished.
Yeah.
Okay. Hi guys, thanks for watching my video. Like, comment, and subscribe. Bye.
Hey.